The purpose of this presentation, of this part especially, is to construct all the ellipses tangent to the three sides of a given triangle. To do that, we need to focus first our attention on the tangent lines to ellipses, like this. So you will see that I will be helped in this work by lots of macros I will create, especially for this work. Let us start by the macros allowing to construct tangent lines to ellipses when the ellipse is given by two foci and a point, or when the ellipse is given by 5 points. When the ellipse is given by two foci and a point, M is given on this ellipse, we start by this line and segment E1, E2. And the director circle of this ellipse associated to F1, centered at F1, radius E1, E2. Ray F1M intersecting the director circle at N, and we know that the tangent line is the perpendicular bisector of F to N. You can check it here, it works. And we record it in this macro. If the ellipse is defined by these 5 points, here is the ellipse, point is given here. We use the macro foci ellipse, which will be created in the next page, allowing us to construct the foci of the ellipse. And so we can use the previous construction. You can see it's exactly the same thing here, here, and here, and it works. Oh, sorry. Let us use these macros here. So let us use this macro tangent ellipse 1. If we click here, here, and here to define the ellipse and a point, we have the tangent line here. And you can check that it works everywhere. We can do the same thing here. Click on the 5 points defining the ellipse and a point here, and we can check that we have obtained all the ellipses, and all the tangent line to this ellipse. Then I will show you now how to obtain the macros allowing to get the center, the axis, and the foci of an ellipse. To get the center of the ellipse, first construction. 3 points, lane AB, parallel line, intersecting point D, midpoints of AB and CD, line IJ intersecting at L and R, midpoint of LR, we have the center of the ellipse. For the axis, we construct 2 points wherever we want on the ellipse, measure the distance, evaluate this expression, because we will use the number 90 in a few seconds, and we want this number to be dependent of D, so we'll not have to use it as an input for our macro. Then we create the center using this macro. Rotate the ellipse around O using this number, 90 degrees. The intersection point, the three first intersection points, midpoints, perpendicular lines, so perpendicular bisectors of these two segments, and we get the axis. For the foci, it's more difficult, more tricky. So we start using the previous macro to get the axis and the center, the intersection points, and we measure A and B. A is it's equal to OS2, B OT2. We evaluate this complicated expression. Why? Because we don't know which one of the two axes is the longest one, so we don't know what is the sine of A square minus B square. So it's a tricky way to evaluate C. Then we have to see where is the longest side. We create this triangle, the midpoint of this side, this perpendicular line, cutting the triangle, the pink triangle, on the longest side at N, create ON, and finally, using the measurement transfer of this number on this vector, we get F1, it's symmetric with respect to O, get F2, and we get the two foci. Does it work? So let us see if this macro works. Click here, we have a center for the axis. Click here, you have this axis. For the foci, click here, you have the foci. It works. So now, how is it possible to construct the two tangent line from a point, two tangent line to an ellipse A from a point M? The ellipse is given by the two foci and a point here. So we start by this line, the intersection points and the segment E1, E2, the director circle associated to F2, the circle centered at M passing through F1, the intersection point between these two circles, and we know that the perpendicular bisector of F1, H1 and F1, H2 are the two tangent lines. To get the contact points, we do this construction. After getting the symmetric point of F2 with respect to T2, same construction, and we get T2. And this macro will give us the tangent lines from M and the contact points. Let us check that on this ellipse and this macro. Let us check how it works. You can see that we have to give an ellipse and a point, and the final object will be the two tangent lines from these points. And you will see also here, from this point to this ellipse. It doesn't work again. The ellipse. Tangent line from this point to this ellipse. I had forgotten how it was working. So you can see that here, the contact point is here. The contact point is here. And if you change the position of this point, it works.